@MontanaDeCamp, and anyone who knows me or can follow me on Twitter, @DeCampMontana, know that Emily Soans is my best friend. And it's been that way since first grade. And I can remember there was a time Emily and I were at daycare with our best friend, Chubby Maddox, and each one of us had some plastic bracelets. They weren't the silly bands everyone was so infatuated with in middle school. They were just plain plastic bracelets. And rather than having them around our wrists or on the table, we were sticking them in our mouths. We'd have part of the bracelet across the top row of our teeth, and the other part across the bottom row. And believe it or not, we actually thought we were cool by doing this, because we thought we were just like the kids in middle school, because we had braces. And looking back on that time, I asked myself why. Why were we sticking plastic things in our mouth, and why were none of the daycare teachers stopping us from this choking hazard? Why were we not playing at the Lego table or doing crafts? Why were we so intrigued by what was going to happen in the next couple of years? We weren't having fun being a brace-free Emerson Elementary kid right then. Go ahead 8 years, and here we are, the end of the end. Most importantly, it's the end of this long graduation ceremony, but also the end of your K-12 journey. And it's crazy to think about, isn't it? Because at first, you didn't realize it, the whole growing up thing. We've heard for you. get the front row, to get the senior lounge, and to get the senior bench, even if it were short-lived. But it was a bittersweet feeling, because what we ultimately realized is the time we thought we had was no longer an endless supply. And the uncertainty of this realization made us appreciate the time we had left so much more. For the first time, we tried focusing on the right now, because it was no longer about our first time doing things, only about our last time. We were finally aware of the ticking clock. Because one day, we walked out for your last time ever being an Indianola high school student. There was no next game, no next match, no more scholastic book fairs, no more Mr. Gala's The Birds and the Bees talks, no more Bonnie stories from Mrs. Carroll's, no more lectures from Pulaski, no more driving up and down the roads of the parking lot to find a spot, and in the end, you decide to give up and make your own spot, headed. No more recess, no more vote for Cam and Sam, no more photos from Troy Bolton or Hannah Montana on them, no more locally famous performing the same song at every 8th grade event, no more being able to smell what is for lunch even though you weren't in the cafeteria. There's no more high school. So here we are, the end of the end. The journey that started in kindergarten is finally over. But today, you walked into the first day that is all yours. A day and a future that is not yet predetermined by the grades ahead of you. Author Zara Nafossi once wrote, "You get a strange feeling when you leave a place. Like you're not only miss the people you love, but you will miss the person who are at this very time and place, because they'll never be this way again." And it's true, because it's all about to change. Never again will the whole class of 2016 be together for another academic year. Never again will you be surrounded by familiar faces, just for whatever the theme may be in the stands for Friday night games. Never again will you be surrounded by familiar faces for the hours and hours of rehearsals. And never again will you be surrounded by the familiar faces that ultimately shaped into the person you are at this very time and place. Today could very well be the last time you see the people sitting on your left and on your right. Friends and faces you've grown accustomed to see 5 days out of the week. It's overwhelming, isn't it, that the people we spent the past 4 years of our life with won't be in our next year. We'll all go off for a couple of months to do our own thing. Attend college, go to work, travel, stay home, whatever it may be. And people are going to try to tell you that the best years of your life are behind you. But don't let that be true. Rather use your years in high school as a platform to the best years of your life. It's easy to sit in a multi-purpose room with plastic bracelets and dream of a future. But then once you get there, you want to be somewhere else. And that's not how it should be. The only time we are guaranteed is the time we have right now. And if we take our time for granted and wish it away, you begin to miss what's happening. So thank you to the class of 2016 for our time together and the memories made, and making this journey a feeling I will always remember. And as we officially say farewell to high school, we say hello to the opportunity filled years to come.